Hi, this is a minute of Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now this week I want to talk about why you should be considering a hybrid framework when building your next app. Okay, so one of the more contested topics in the app development sphere is the hybrid framework or Phonegap, Cordova, Corona SDK, that kind of thing, versus native debate. And a few years ago, I mean, it's been going on for years, ever since, you know, Phonegap came out. And just to give you an idea, just to let you know what a hybrid framework is, if you're unfamiliar with the term, that's something like Phonegap you may have heard of. It's something that sits on top of the operating system. So I mentioned this a few weeks ago. Let me bring up this graphic again, where you have iOS code or Android code, and you would write your code on either one of those, or you know, two sets of code bases. However, using a hybrid framework, what you could do is build your code on top of that code, and this framework will translate everything from what you're trying to do into the two different platforms. So if, say, iPhone takes a picture a certain way and Android takes a picture a different way using two sets of code, this framework will take that and say, and give you one common set of code. And this framework could be in many languages, like Phonegap, as I mentioned, or Cordova, as it's also called, is done in JavaScript and HTML. It's very, you know, easy to use and it's very, very powerful. However, you also have things like Xamarin, which can be done in C Sharp. You have Corona SDK, which we use, which should be done in Lua, and you have, you know, there's lots of them. There's just loads of them. These frameworks, they work really well, but they're very restrictive. So if you have something new that comes out in iOS, for example, let's say the iOS Watch and then the Android Watch, these both have different APIs, and those hybrid frameworks haven't quite caught up with them yet. And the funny thing about the app market is that when iPhone comes out with something to give it a competitive edge, then Android eventually will copy it. Then Android will come up with something that gives them a competitive edge, and eventually iPhone will copy it, which is great. I mean, that's the reason we have this exciting market and things keep pushing forward. However, sometimes there's a little bit of lag for those hybrid frameworks to catch it. So anyway, a few years ago, the debate was there's some developers who say always do native because native is much more performant. You get much better performance on native than you do on Phonegap or the other hybrid frameworks. However, I think this one of the things that I contend over, you know, especially now here in July 2015, is that if you're not using a hybrid framework, more often than not, you're spending more money than you need to. Now, if you're doing something that's really low level, say you're using, say, the watch or the heart rate monitor or something that's kind of new and you can't do through one of these hybrid frameworks, yeah, by all means, go native. But you do have two sets of costs. You have the Android development costs or the iPhone development costs. Many people will just ignore Android altogether, so, you know, 80% of the market, and just go for iPhone, which you know, delivers more money. My opinion here, and again, this, you know, for the last few years, we have seen the hybrid framework frameworks have been really advancing. Not only that, but because of Moore's law, we've been seeing the processing power of both the iPhone and the Android just getting more and more powerful each time, where these little delays in things that made them feel a little bit sluggish before hardly exist at all. And you got things like the crosswalk framework on Cordova, which will take an old Android device, which is using the old Android browser, and put the new Chrome browser into it, and it just adds like 10 or 20 megabytes to the file. But, you know, it's the performance hit, or the performance boost is enormous. So we're starting to see like a lot of innovation coming out from the hybrid area, to the point where, you know, when I tell clients and they call me, is like, what we really want to do, unless we can't help it at all, is go with one of the hybrid frameworks. We wanted to reduce costs as much as we can and have a code base which we can, you know, write one time with a few tweaks for each platform for both, you know, Android, iPhone, and, you know, if you're, you know, ambitious, then Windows Phone as well. So so that's my message now. Whereas a few years ago, there was, you know, it did feel a bit strange saying, yeah, maybe we should go hybrid. You know, we'll test it out in terms of speed. Now it's almost crazy not to consider it as a first option unless there's absolutely no way forward. And many app developers are probably disagree with that. In fact, comment and let me know if you disagree with that, because you know, in my opinion, with the Ionic framework, with all the new frameworks that are coming out, you really should be looking at a hybrid if you can. And if there's something you need and you can't find a plugin for it or build a plugin for it, then go through native. So that's it for this week's Minute of Overpass. Now, if you're watching this on the iTunes podcast, please leave a review. I'd love to know what you think. And if you're watching this on YouTube, please like the video, comment on the video, you know, or YouTube or LinkedIn or Facebook. I'd love to know what you think. That's it for this week. I'll talk to you next week. Bye.